Hello, everyone, and welcome to a brief tutorial of the mechanics of the roulette game in Alundra. Now, I realize you're probably thinking, wait a minute, buddy, you're about 17 years late to this party. Yes, I know. But currently, I'm finishing up a Let's Play of Alundra, and I had a bunch of footage of the roulette game just lying around the cutting room floor, so I figured I might as well put it to some use and contribute to the greater good, rather than just let it all go to waste. Bear in mind, though, that if you are playing this game on an emulator, you're better off just using save states to complete this particular minigame. If, however, like me, you purchased it from PSN or are playing an original retail disc, you might want to pay attention to what I'm about to explain. The single most important thing to know here is that the wheel can only actually land on the five spaces farthest away from where it starts, and the easiest way to figure that out is to start at the blinking light, count eight spaces in either direction, that'll give you the space exactly opposite the light. The wheel can land on that space or the two spaces to either side of it for a total of five. The wheel has 16 spaces, and being able to narrow down your options to five of those 16 is pretty important. As you can see here, the range of spaces encompassed in this example is two reds, two greens, and a blue. And unfortunately, I've guessed incorrectly, but you probably are already getting a sense for how this works. You figure out the range of spaces, in this case it's two reds, two blues, and a black, and whichever color appears in the highest number, that's the one you want to pick. In this case, both red and blue have the same odds, 2 out of 5, so it doesn't really matter which one you go for. You'd be crazy to choose green, though, because green is not part of this range at all, and if you pick it, you're guaranteed to lose. In this example, the odds are a little bit different. The wheel can potentially land on a green space, two red spaces, the black space, or one blue space. So in this case, you should pick red, since at 2 out of 5, it has the highest odds of coming up. Unfortunately, because the distribution of colors around the wheel isn't even, each different position gives you different odds which may or may not be favorable, but in this case, I lucked out and happened to guess correctly. It's really just all about maximizing your odds, that's the most important thing here. In this case, I have a 3 out of 5 chance of landing on green, so green is the obvious selection here. And again, because of the uneven distribution of spaces around the wheel, there is a single best case scenario, which I'm about to show you guys next. Also, if the black space falls within range, you have a 1 out of 5 chance of instantly losing no matter what you do. So again, not all starting positions will yield favorable odds. Now, this is the best case scenario. The potential range on which the wheel can land here is 4 green spaces and 1 blue space. So, obviously you should pick green. You'd be stupid to pick red because you will always lose if you pick red in this situation. Now, I'm assuming here that outcomes are not forced on the player, because they may be. I haven't been able to statistically corroborate this, but I've had a suspiciously high rate of occurrence of that best case scenario, and I picked green, and repeatedly, and I'm talking several times in a row, the wheel would land on that one blue space. So, I don't know, guys, assuming that there isn't anything else going on here, that there are no other forces at work, this is the best possible way that you can hope to maximize your odds of winning the roulette game. And let me just make clear, guys, if you're going for the Gilded Falcons in the casino games, you need to win each game, including the roulette, 4 times. That means getting to the final round and winning the final round 4 times. And for the other 2 games, that's fine, because they're skill-based. But because you have no direct control over the roulette game, its design just results in horrendous amounts of time spent trying to get the Gilded Falcon. So I hope this has been helpful to at least somebody. In any case, thank you for watching.